Well, hello and a warm welcome to the Sound of Silence with myself, DrumPIPO. And you know, when you see me, it's going to be lit. Right, your Saturday is just about to get better. Today, I'm hanging out with one of my favorite artists in the country of South Africa. Some of you will remember her from Joyous Celebration, others from being a backing vocalist for some of the big names like Huma Sakela and Judith Sipuma, Lira and stuff like that. And we'll be having a lovely chat here, right here on the Sound of Silence. She will also be performing some beautiful music right here on the Sound of Silence. You don't want to miss out on any of this. This show is made possible by DrumPIPO Music and Music Production and a film house based in Ferry Glen, Pretoria East. If you need any of their services, they have studio recording and live sound engineering and stuff like that they do for all your functions. If you need any of their services, please go ahead, check them out on their social media or contact them on Facebook and they will assist you beautifully. Also, East Havens, these guys are a music shop based also in Ferry Glen, Pretoria East, and if you need any of their services, come in store. You can check them out on their websites, on social media, everywhere. But they have lovely stuff all over the place. They will assist you and help you get every musical instrument that you have been dreaming for so long. Once again, a warm welcome to the Sound of Silence with myself, DrumPIPO. Stay tuned.
The Sound of Silence with DrumPIPO.
All right, welcome back to the Sound of Silence with myself, DrumPIPO. And today I am hanging out with an amazing sister. You know, this woman can sing the angels down. Look, I don't want to talk a lot. Brenda Mtambo, welcome to the Sound of Silence.
Thank you, Silence, for having me. Thank you.
It's great to have you. Who is Brenda Mtambo?
I am born in a village. It's a village called Mpangeni. I was born there in Ngwelizane Hospital, and then I then grew up in a township called Mlazi in Durban.
Okay.
Raised by my grandmother. We are only two at home, just me and my sister, and also my cousins and everyone else. You know, the African families have.
That's right.
How we are raised. And then all my life, my younger life, I was in Durban. I grew up there. My music then came from home because we are a musical home at home. Everyone.
That's right. So everybody in the family sings, basically.
Yes.
Your father.
My mom is a singer, not professionally. I'm the only one who's doing it professionally. But they can hold a note very well. Don't have to teach them anything. They know how to.
Wow. So what is their response when they sing your song? I mean, how does your mother feel? How do you think she feels when she sings your song?
I think they are happy. At first, they never really understood this music thing. You know, parents, they always feel like, ish, this music thing, you know.
How far is it going to go?
Yeah, because I've been singing all my life from when I was really, really, really young. And I think they could see that my direction would be music, you know. But they were driving me away from music for the longest time. So they didn't want me to sing in high school because it was affecting, obviously, the studies. But I forced my way through. I will even lie that I'm going to school, I'm going to a gig. I forced my way through it. But they are supportive, you know.
But you were with Joyous for quite a long time. And that's what, most people classify you under as a gospel music musician and stuff like that. I mean, how do you handle that? Because you don't even have,
I don't even handle
song.
It. You know, I've always said I was never a gospel singer. I was in a gospel group.
Yeah.
Which is very fortunate for me and very blessed and lucky to be in that amazing group, you know, in a Joyous Celebration. I've always known that I wasn't going to sing gospel music.
That's right.
From the onset.
But why is that though?
Because I feel like music should be something that is flowing out of you, that is flowing naturally.
Yeah.
So I didn't resonate with gospel because I didn't grow up listening to gospel or being influenced by gospel.
Okay.
My music was influenced by Bosim Hlongo's,
the
Mfazo Mnyama, the Maskandi stuff. So because we are very rural at home, so I remember my grandfather used to play guitar.
Okay.
So we loved Maskandi music.
Okay.
So and then I went to Shembe church.
Yeah.
So that also my music then and then I then listened to jazz at the Anita Baker's.
Yeah.
You know, then when I was now in the music and listening to music, then I was drawn into Oleta Adams because of my voice, and I could relate to those kind of voices. Mm. So when I wanted to do my own thing, I wanted it to be authentic, to be who I am. So gospel, I can forge it because I'm a singer. Anybody can.
So in future, I mean, the fans shouldn't expect any gospel.
You know what I normally do? Because I'm a very spiritual person as well.
Yeah.
You know, I'm very grounded in Christ.
Yeah.
I pray. So it's my life to worship. Mm. You know, I don't have to record an album to worship.
That's
I can worship.
That's right.
But there are moments you find that in my shows when I feel my spirit leads me there. Mm. I go there. I do a gospel song.
Wow.
Because I can, you know.
Yeah.
But as a choice of career and a choice of genre, that when I want to put a performance, you know, I know that everything that I do is natural when I'm doing what I'm doing, because
that's
know it from when I was younger.
That's right.
You know,
that's
so with gospel, I'm just singing a song that I'm feeling in my heart, and you can be blessed. You can be blessed, but what resonates with me is what I'm doing, and then I do it authentically and from my being naturally. Like, honestly, my music, I don't do much.
Mm.
I just breathe and do it. I don't think about it.
That's right. How did you get into Joyous Celebration?
I went for an audition. I remember we were three.
Yeah.
We were supposed to be six girls because we were in a group. So we were three. We went to an audition. They loved us.
Mm.
You know, they're like, oh, these kids,
we're
kids.
All three of you.
All three of us. Mm. Then they took us into Joyous Celebration. That's how we got in.
Wow. Well, how old were you?
I was 19.
Wow, 19. And when you left home, like at the age of 19, joining a big group like that, didn't you have like any big head or?
No, I was, you know, I'm not.
Or were you more
like
surprised
that.
Of what was happening all around you?
I think it took me a while to actually understand that I'm actually in a big group, that people now starting to know who I am, which is like strange.
Yeah.
Because I didn't think that was going to happen, especially because I was always in the back.
Mm.
I only sang after my fourth year in Joyous, or fifth year, to be in front.
Okay.
I was always in the choir.
Mm.
But I was always the one people knew by name.
That's right.
So
that's
people
right.
loved me from the choir. They really loved me from Joyous. You know, they really loved me from being there. They're like, we love your stage persona.
Yeah.
You know, they were drawn to me in a way that I couldn't understand.
Yeah.
I did not grow a big head because I was not raised like that.
That's right.
Humility at home is
That's
one
right.
thing. Respecting people
That's
is
right.
one thing. So I've learned that all my life. Even now, I'm trying to instill that in my
in
children
the kids,
as well, to be respectful of people. You are never too important.
That's right.
To disrespect anyone.
That's right. That's right.
Yeah.
When you were switching from gospel to jazz or soul, I mean, was it scary?
I think scary is not the right word. I was not scared because I've always known that I wanted to do this. But obviously, it was life-changing because then it meant I'm not going to have an income to launch my career.
Mm.
So I was always receiving money. I was always performing. I was always a backing singer for this and that.
Yeah.
Then, so when I then shifted, that was a big shift.
Mm.
It meant I need to survive through my saving that I've had.
Yeah.
Then they're all gone. 6 months later, I had to move in with friends.
Yeah.
Stay
yeah.
with friends.
Yeah.
Because I was not. I was very certain that I don't want to go back to where I was.
Mm.
So I wanted growth in my life. So then it meant I need to be uncomfortable.
Mm.
So that was like a moment for me. I remember very well. I used to stay with some of my friends and like, can I stay with you for like 6 months, man?
Yeah.
And then I'll move and stay with the other one because I was building my own thing.
Mm.
And then when I felt confident now to say I can then, you know, stay on my own.
Yeah.
I got myself a room. I stay in that room.
Yeah.
From when I used to have a flat where I was staying in a flat, everything was nice.
Yeah. Yeah.
So then I got a small room
so
that I can fulfill everything that I wanted
That's
to do.
Right.
And I did all of that, man. And we're here now.
Yeah, and it's all about being focused, because I mean that's the part that a lot of people don't see.
Yeah.
And they never hear.
Yeah.
They only see, you know, you on the big stage with all these beautiful lights and stuff like that.
They see you when in your glorious years.
Yeah.
In your glorious years, they never see
the time you were praying and crying to God alone.
Yeah, the time we didn't even have food to eat.
That's right.
You know.
That's right.
They never see all of that.
That's right. No, excellent. I still want to talk a bit more about this, you know, and What do you have in mind to perform for us?
I'm going to perform I Love You, a song that I really love. People love this song so much.
I love
it's called
too.
I Love You.
I love it.
And then I'm going to do with Afro. It's called Ungawam Forever.
Wow. All right. No, I'm not going to waste any much of your time. Take it away. And then after that, we'll come and have some more chat. Thank you so much. Welcome back to the Sound of Silence, and you heard that performance, my sister. That music was good.
Thank you.
I could feel all the goosebumps on my body.
Thanks a lot.
It's like I could just go and look for my wife again and propose from the start.
Propose again
with that same music in the background.
Propose again.
What inspired that music? I love you.
I write from experience. I write from what I'm going through. I write from what I observe. I Love You is a song. It's a love song, obviously, you know, but it's an affirmation song that you need to often tell your wife that I love you, you know, you are important.
I'm sure she'll be happy about this.
You need to often tell you need to tell your partner how much you love them.
Yeah.
They need to, especially us women, we love to be told.
That's right.
To be affirmed.
That's right.
A lot of the time that we are loved all the time. So that's where the song basically was coming from, and I feel like a lot of people can resonate with the message and they love it. Yeah. Or especially the couples, they really love the song.
That's right.
Yeah.
What is this one thing that you would change in this whole industry if you're given the chance?
I would make sure that whoever enters the industry has information of what the industry entails. I'll change that. I wouldn't make anyone sign anything without understanding of wow, the business works. I'll take them to a workshop to understand what they're getting themselves into.
Yeah, yeah.
Because often we find that a lot of artists, they find themselves in situations where someone signed a contract that they had no understanding of what that's the contract is
did
all
you,
about.
Did you ever find yourself in such a situation?
Not really. I haven't signed a lot of, I've had one contract.
Okay.
I really avoid signing anything in this industry.
Yeah.
I've had two albums. I only signed for one. So,
so the second one, what happened to it?
No, I signed the second one. The first one I didn't sign.
Okay.
So I was actually helped and we avoided signing anything because when you sign, you're signing your life away. So we're like, okay, I understood that my first album would be like my business card.
That's right.
It was going to be an album that is launching me into the business. My second album was with a label, a big label.
Yeah.
So I had to sign, but then I had to understand exactly what I was signing.
That's right.
So I'm lucky enough to get information. I mean,
some lawyers to look
lawyers,
through for you.
Yeah. And I didn't even have money, but I have a lot of relationships that I've created around.
Yeah.
I have everybody. I've got doctors as friends.
Yeah.
I've got accountants as friends.
That's right.
I've got a lot of, so I can always get help.
Yeah.
But it doesn't mean I don't pay. I do pay. If I need something urgently, I can say, please look at this. You know, they're like, no, don't sign that.
Yeah.
You know.
What scares you the most? What is your biggest fear in the industry?
I think the biggest fear is the uncertainty. You know, our industry is, there are no guarantees in what we do. We live by faith, you know.
I get you.
So that is the biggest fear of not being able to
know what tomorrow holds.
Yeah, of not knowing tomorrow. But I try not to live in the fear. I try to be optimistic, to make plans. To make plans. I always have plans.
That's right.
I work on my plans. I execute my plans. So that I know what I'm working on in the next year. I know what I'm working on, you know.
Yeah.
So I try to be ahead all the time, you know. You know. And also, I'm not trying this one. This one, I'm doing it. I don't want to be always singing, even if I don't want to sing. So I'm venturing into other businesses.
Okay.
You know, but within the music. Because I love being in the music industry. Okay. I can always...
But you started your own label, right?
Yes.
Now.
I have my own label, Busa Music. So everything I'm doing, I do it under my own, my productions.
Wow, that's right.
Everything I do it under my own Busa Music. With something that I'm growing. It's growing. So obviously...
Have you signed any artist yet?
I haven't. But it's one of the things that I would really love to do, sign other artists. Because I believe in real talent, and I want to push that, like real talented, you know, and unique somebodies. So I will do that in the near future. So you see now I'm planning the future. I'm planning where I want to go
and
the management side of things as well, because I feel like a great artist can be great without a proper structure and management, a place, you know, around an artist. An artist can't do anything.
Yeah, I mean, the music itself takes only like 25% to 30% of your career.
The rest is a team.
Yeah.
You need a team. So that's what I'm working on. That's what I need to work on as well in terms of my business and what I see myself.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Will you say that being a female artist is an advantage in this industry?
Advantage?
Yeah.
I wouldn't say advantage. I would say disadvantage.
Why?
Because, you know, being a female artist, number one, you are not taken serious. That's why I'm going to go back to this thing. That's why I launched my Women Rise event.
Yeah.
Women Rise is about women, empowering women in the music business. Because we are easily taken advantage of, because most of the time, it's like we don't know what we're doing. We are just concerned
like
about being
world.
Pretty. We want to be sexualized. We want to be all these things. So I am saying a woman can be a boss and can be on top.
That's
can
right.
Be, you know.
That's right.
We can be in control. So at the moment, I don't think we are taken serious, honestly. I don't think, even in positions, if you go into executives and you go into this high in the board, there's only few. I'm now a board member at Sampra, you know.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
We're only two
women.
Women. The rest is
my
me.
Goodness. How many members are the board?
Over 12. It's a lot. Actually, it's over that. Yeah, it's over that. But it's only two females.
Wow.
You know, so that shows you that a lot of, I don't even blame the industry about this one. I blame us women sometimes, you know.
Yeah.
When we don't want to take a stand for anything. We just want to be on stage and sing. Then that's where the problem is.
So what does the future hold for all the people that are crazy about your music? I mean, what should they expect next?
Music. I have a lot of music that I want to put out.
Yeah.
They need to expect music. I'm going to start releasing music.
2020?
Of course. 2020, I want to release.
How
I can
many
even
albums
have
are
three
coming?
Albums. I'm joking.
I
have a lot of material, you know. I have a tour that is already advertised, you know, next year. Next year, man, I wanna go all over the world, as you've said it.
I've prophesied into the atmosphere.
You're prophesying into the atmosphere. So I wanna go globally. I really would like to go to Africa as well, other African countries, because we are also Africans.
Yeah.
In other African countries, you know, I wanna go to UK. I want to expand and just, you know.
Yeah. So African countries, UK, if they are watching, they should just start booking. I mean,
please.
The diary is cleared.
Listen.
Everything else will wait.
Go on my page, right? DM me.
All right. No, it was really nice having you. Where can people find your music?
It's available in every live streaming or
platform.
Digital platform.
My iTunes, music is there. Deezer, iTunes, Spotify.
Everywhere you can find my music. In every music that sells music, also you find my albums there.
Wow.
My music is everywhere. If you can't find it, call me.
Yeah.
Or
email
me again.
All right. No, thank you so much for coming to hang out with me. I can't wait any longer. The stage is all yours.
Thank
Please
you.
Do your second
thank
song.
Thank you so much.
Thank
you
so
a
much.
Lot.
Okay, bye.
Nakupenda. No
right, guys, that's it for the day. Thank you so much for hanging out with me, myself, and my guest right here on The Sound of Silence, Brenda Mtambo. I hope you had a lovely time. I did have a great time. And thank you also for hanging out with us. Look, if you are new to this show, please consider subscribing. Don't forget to hit the bell so you get all the future notification of our upcoming shows. Until then, I will see you next week, Saturday. God bless.